ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to SABC3, where the stage is yours. My name is Khanyi Mbau, and I am your host right here on The Scoop, the only genuine spot where you get celebrity news and a closer look to the entertainment sphere. So tonight is a jam-packed show as usual, and thank you so much for tuning in for the past episodes and keeping us on your screen and trusting us to give you the scoop and the juice. Remember, it is hashtag The Scoop and at The Scoop Africa on social media, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your interaction, and I'd like to say at Bapiwe says that the hit list is actually the hit on The Scoop. I agree, because it gives me superpowers. I get to see into the future. I love it as well. And now underscore Marwe says that well done to Loli. She did an awesome job, and that's why I gave her a golden spoon. Stick around, because I have a menu that is going to keep you asking for more. We're talking about gossip on social media, and on the menu today we'll be talking about Gigi Hadid and her sister. Stick around, because you want to know what those two are getting up to. Kerry Washington's beautiful fashion. We'll also be celebrating birthdays like Maurice Page's and Zendaya. So we called one of our friends right here on The Scoop, Loli Ndlovu. She joined us with the team. They went down to see David Gao's Blacks Only. As he does it every year, he makes the country laugh. They spoke about USBs. They talk about politicians. They spoke about everything that happened in the year. But check it out. Let me not spoil it for you. Go.
We are at the biggest comedy show in the country that features established and new comedians. And of course, the prestigious David Gao is going to be the MC for tonight's show. And you know what they say, black by popular demand. It's going to be an amazing show.
It's nice when you're performing a gig and you can see people's faces in the audience. Because they feel it. They're with you every step of the way.
At Blacks Only on Saturday night, it was obvious that comedians are finding inspiration everywhere. From Babes Wodumo's missing USB stick, to awkward toilet situations, drunken one-night stands, and frustrating interruptions during one-on-one DIY sessions.
We have to talk about these things. We grew up in an era where our parents didn't. We used to ask, where does children come from?
Your mother came here with you from the hospital. I don't know. She came back one day, and then I asked her, where's the receipt? And then she said, no, she didn't take a receipt. Now we're stuck with you. And then you find out when you're age 17 by mistake, oh, this one, okay.
David Gao gave a selfie photographer a chance to shine after she explained why she was late.
So the show is starting to,
if you could be stranded on an island with any celebrity, who would it be? It was clear that Skalk Bazainhote had The Rock on his mind.
Because he's big and he's strong, and I think like he'll keep me warm at night and break branches and pick fruits.
After the show, David Gao expressed his excitement about being in the presence of one of South Africa's brightest stars.
Khanyi Mbau is here. Khanyi Mbau is here. You just can't see her. Yeah, yeah. She is see-through. She's here. Khanyi's here.
Wow, a man that never runs out of jokes and keeps South Africa laughing year in and year out. We gotta love you, David Gao. Remember to catch him every Friday right here on SABC 3 at 7:30. But if you'd like to see what happened at the Emperor's, stick around, because at the end of the show, we'll be showing you exclusive clips that we found, and no one else has them in the country, trust me. If you want to laugh a little, this is the place that you need to be. Well, it's time to celebrate another local birthday, so bring out the cake, the candles, and the champagne. We'd like to say happy birthday to Maurice Page. Here he is.
On the 5th of September, Maurice Page celebrates his birthday. Throughout the year, but especially on his birthday, Maurice reflects on his memories of the amazing woman who raised him.
My great-grandma, she is the one actually that brought me to life, you know, because I grew up without my mother and my father. So she has been my anchor my whole life, and she passed away when I was 18 years old. So she's always been my memory. She's the one who actually keep me going.
Maurice moves seamlessly between theatre, film and television, having made his mark as Calvin in Isidingo. On the 29th of September, Maurice will be at the South African premiere of Pop, Lock and Roll, a feature film which he plays the lead character, Raps.
I think this is going to be officially South Africa's biggest dance movie ever. And now it's finally time to release it here, and it's perfect timing for September.
I must say that you're quite fit. I like you. I like you a lot. But I'm carried away. Let's go to Zendaya. She celebrated her birthday, and here she is. Let's see how she lives her life.
On the 1st of September, Zendaya celebrates her birthday. Born in Oakland, California, Zendaya Marie Coleman was destined for a career in the spotlight. As the daughter of a stage manager, she spent much of her youth hanging out at the California Shakespeare Theatre. When she was old enough, the aspiring star joined the company's youth program and appeared in several of its productions. She also danced in a hip-hop group, modeled, and played several sports. Daya, as her friends call her, really began her rise to fame in 2010 when she was cast on the Disney Channel show Shake It Up, alongside fellow rising star Bella Thorne. A true triple threat, the starlet showcased both her acting and dancing skills in the series and eventually also recorded some of the songs that featured on the show. In 2017, the brunette beauty made her big screen debut in Spider-Man Homecoming. Happy birthday, Zendaya!
So when you date a guy for over 10 years and the love is not easy, but you fight through it, it ends up in a beautiful story and they live happily ever after. This weekend, well, the past weekend on Saturday, Regine Gabinde, the Kawulas, got married to beauty in Durban at a beautiful ceremony that was hosted and emceed by Thibaut Touch. Filled with celebrities and businessmen that he has worked with, we'd like to say to them, congratulations, and here you are with your spooning spoons. Love wins! I got to hang out with a great duo and an international act together. They were shooting a video, but you need to stick around to find out who they are. And trust me, it's someone you like. See you after the break. And remember, it is hashtag The Scoop, because we all want to know. I'll see you when you come back. Welcome back, everybody, right here on SABC3, where the stage is yours. So we're talking about fashion and we're talking about the runway. Well, Gigi Hadid has finally confirmed that she will be joining her sister Bella Hadid back on the Victoria's Secret runway. So they will be walking together. And I'd love to see if her father's going to join it. What do you do when your two daughters are doing such a fashion show? But let's check it out.
Gigi Hadid has finally confirmed that she'll be joining her sister Bella at the 2017 Victoria's Secret Fashion Show, as she took to Instagram to post a sexy throwback video and announce that she'll be hitting the runway later in the year. In the caption for the video, the model noted that it's forever and ever a dream come true to be asked back to the VS show. She then thanked everyone involved for another unforgettable opportunity, as every aspect makes her feel like a dreaming kid again. Gigi's younger sister, Bella, only confirmed that she'll be returning a day or so before, after the pair caused the fans to worry that they wouldn't be part of the annual event. Thankfully, it doesn't look like either of them would miss the show for the world, and we count on them both appearing for many years to come.
Seeing that we are on the Maurice tip and we are talking about Maurice Page's birthday, I thought, like I did mention, that you're so fit and I like it, you know? Could we see more of your biceps, your triceps, your body, how you do it? Just for the girls. Motivation for summer bodies, you know? I'm not saying anything else.
In 2016, Maurice competed in the Arnold Classic Europe Ace, which was hosted by Arnold Schwarzenegger. He is passionate about bodybuilding and sees it as a way to advance his career as an actor.
I so badly want to go into action movies, which is actually my big project for 2018. That's the reason why I'm doing bodybuilding, so I can make more money, first of all, and be in good shape. First South African colored boy from Cape Town who's gonna make it in action movies, doing his own stunt and being in good shape and directing it. The thing is, for me to stay in shape is just to eat clean all the time. Besides training weights, I run a lot, I play rugby, I'm always active. I got involved with a woman, she was a personal trainer. Beautiful, beautiful, I still thank her up until today. But she is the main reason why I got into it. She affected me with a bug. And, you know, it's almost a year and I've achieved so much.
Yes, ladies, you can hashtag me at The Scoop and say thank you. But would like to say, Maurice, thank you so much for those giant abs and giant biceps. And for that, we're giving you a giant spoon. Ah. My favorite part of the show, social media buzz. Let's see what's been keeping us on our phones and making our phones buzz, buzz, buzz and finish all our battery life. To start off on Sunday night, it could never be the same without a little tour. And this week, lovely Pearl Tusi and Sizwe Dlomo chose to be head on head. Now, when two people that look good, right, and they're both yellow bones fight, we can't say that they're hating on each other. So I don't know what we call it. They were correcting each other, apparently, on social media when Pearl tweeted talking about some influential people in the African sphere. And Sizwe chose to come out and say, no, Pearl, this is not how it's said. It is so and so. She then responded and said, why do you have to correct me in a public space instead of texting me? The tour took over and it took a long time. But what was nice and juicy for everyone is these people were friends and they look good, because usually tours take two people that don't look nice. I don't know, am I making sense? But moving right along, we all know that our deputy president has been in the news over the weekend. He was caught with his pants down. He said that he is not a sugar daddy, but yes, he did cheat on his wife. I don't know, man, what's going on? I don't know, but we'll forgive you. I don't know, because he came out and he owned it, right? So let's forgive the guy and give him a break. See, when you write a book, this is what happens. All your exes come out, the skeletons too, because you've opened Pandora's box. Euphonic has come out to tell us what he said at the Magistrates Court when he was with Bonang, right? Now, Euphonic has come out to say instead of him hitting her, it's Bonang that kept hitting him. Every time she got drunk, they would end up in a violent spat. Right? She would then take a knife and slit her wrists, claiming to call the police and saying that Euphonic is the one that did this to her. Wow. Well, I'd like to give you both a salad spoon because it is a toss-up. It is messy. Can't you both just get along and just get boyfriends and girlfriends and be happy and just leave each other alone? What I love about red carpets is the people that come and play. Kerry Washington never gets it wrong, even on a day where she feels low or absent. So I would like to look at her style and who she is and how she gets ready for such events. Let's check it out.
Kerry Washington is known for keeping a super keen eye on what's hot and what's not. In 2014, she debuted her baby bump at the Globes in a fitted Balenciaga number, while at the Academy Awards, Kerry went for a Greek goddess-inspired look, draping her belly in a purple Jason Wu. Never one to skip award season, Kerry stepped out in another amazing Oscars look the following year. The champagne peplum-style dress featured a dramatic chiffon skirt, which was fully embroidered with glass beads and pearls. It was a very different image from the style she'd chosen for the Globes a few weeks earlier. Taking a fashion risk there, she pulled off a metallic color-blocked Mary Catranzi gown and landed on many best-dressed lists that night. Clearly more confident than ever, experimenting with daring looks, Kerry opted for an edgy leather bodice and white flowing skirt at the 2016 Academy Awards. With the help of the thigh-high slit, she perfectly showed off her toned legs and put the focus on her gorgeous diamond cluster earrings. The actress pulled her hair back in a slightly disheveled ponytail and got rave reviews from fashion critics. Back at the Golden Globes in 2017, Washington showed off her slim post-baby body only 3 months after giving birth to her second child. The actress once again opted for a see-through fabric, wowing in a glimmering gold gown from Dolce & Gabbana with black detailing and adding drama with a midnight plum lip color. No matter the dress, no matter the occasion, fans and photographers continue to go mad for style chameleon Kerry Washington.
Kerry, I love your style. If there's anything of those pieces that you don't want, simply put them in DHL on a plane and bring them here. I will accept them with a smile and a thank you because they rock. South Africa is becoming such a pan-African country because all African artists come here to shoot their videos and make music with our own. So later on in the show, I've got a scoop for you and I'd like to show you which African artist came over to make music with our own. Stick around. Years of an event, right? And it's called Jazz on the Lake. It's got the likes of Sibongile, Zamajobe, well, your greatest artist that you can ever imagine on a jazz stage. But our team went down there and they got to speak to Amanda Black. Let's hear what she had to say.
It felt so amazing to be on that stage. Oh my goodness, the audience is amazing. The love was so real. Singing along to all the songs, like it was overwhelming. And it's a great day, the sun is out, everybody just came out in numbers with their families, with their loved ones. It was just an amazing experience and I just had a great time. And I also fell, but that was one of the highlights of the set.
I love you so much.
Amanda is featured on La Source's hit single, I Do. In 1 month, the video has gained 1.8 million views on YouTube.
It's a love song. Everybody's getting married. It's spring. And it also pushes black love, because that's what the song is about. People must just fall in love, because I feel like in music and also in social media, people are, men are trash, all these horrible hashtags, that love, it needs to be reintroduced to us as a young society.
I bow my head in shame. You know, artists always fall off the stage. I'm one victim in Nelspruit and Mpumalanga. I also know a few rappers. So Amanda, you're not on your own. I could literally say you have now become a household name because you have fallen into your fame. Congratulations. But nothing else, just speaking about things that don't fall, things that always come up and keep us happy. When I look into my little vision here, I see a list that's going to make us so, so happy. Here is the hit list. Enjoy.
Abdul, you will travel to England. You will present the Queen with a ceremonial coin.
Whatever you do, you must not look at Her Majesty.
She has requested Mr. Kareem be her personal footman.
How do you like your Scottish costumes?
They're very scratchy. Everything in Scotland is scratchy.
You are a servant no longer. You will teach me Urdu and the Quran.
Not this Indian peasant. Or we will have you certified insane.
I am perhaps disagreeably attached to power. But I am anything but insane. I am Queen of England. Empress of India. Has risen on his own merits. Now, he is my friend.
I haven't been as happy as this for you.
My name is Augie Pullman. Next week, I start fifth grade. And since I've never been to real school before, I'm pretty much totally petrified.
Dear God, please make them be nice to you.
I've had 27 surgeries. They tell me to breathe, to see, to hear without a hearing aid, but none of them have made me look ordinary.
The incubator, Bunsen burners. Oh, and this is an eraser.
You know what an eraser is, right?
Look at his face. I've never seen anything that ugly in my life.
If I looked like him, I'd swear I'd put a hood over my face.
You are not ugly, Augie.
You just have to say that because you're my mom.
Because I'm your mom, it counts the most, because I know you the most.
You don't have to do this.
I don't know what you're talking about, Augie.
You don't have to pretend is all I'm saying.
Augie!
Okay, I'm really sorry. Why are you sitting here then?
Because I want some nice friends for a change.
Me too.
Who is it that I aspire to be? That is the question that we should be asking ourselves all the time.
Hey, Jack, come sit here.
In a sec. I'd like to be able to control the weather.
That would be your superpower? That sounds pretty lame.
What would you do?
I'd be invisible.
You're the toughest kid in that school. Show them.
You can't blend in when you were born to stand out.
You ever thought about having plastic surgery?
Dude, this is after plastic surgery. It takes a lot of work to look this good.
I'm Molly Bloom. Do you know about me?
I read your indictment after I got your call last night.
Do you understand that you are charged with operating an illegal gambling business?
I was in a room with movie stars, directors, and business titans. They were going all in, all the time.
Let's play.
You spent 8 years in Hollywood and 2 years in New York running the world's most exclusive and decadent man cave.
Have you seen the other names in your indictment? Come on, Marty, just how deep into the Russian mob were you?
Your exposure's crazy.
You got 2.8 million on the street right now.
You're gonna get blown up.
You managed to build a multi-million dollar business using not much more than your wits.
I'm about to be charged in federal court.
Well, nobody's perfect.
There's a new offer on the table. Complete immunity. We hand over the hard drives.
You've seen what's on those hard drives. Families, lives, careers will be ruined.
Why are you in this alone? Where are the people you're protecting by not telling the whole story?
Keep on turning. Primary, keep on.
Mary.
So we've been to the future, right? I'd like to go into earlier on today. This is where I spoke to the Major League DJs to see their behind the scenes of the video. So allow me to walk back into today. Yes, as in right now, while you wait for me and I come back. See you now.
So as I said to you early on in the studio, let me step away and show you what I got up to today during the day. It's in Houghton in a beautiful mansion, and the Major League DJs are shooting You Can Do Better video. Okay, so you guys have become men of status, right? Like everything you do must be on a top-notch status. You must smell like status. You must play like status. You must act like status. You must just look like status, right?
Yeah, you gotta look like money.
You know, and money is a status.
No, you gotta look like you're doing something, like you're trying to improve yourself, you know? I think that's a man of status, you know? Someone who's hustling, trying to always grow and build them, themselves and those next to them.
Do better is just basically about how, you know, well, I'm speaking to the ladies, you know, how sometimes, you know what I'm saying, you can find yourself in a situation where you're with a man and he's not treating you right, and there's always been that guy that's just watching, has been, and it's telling, it's like, listen, if you can just give me a chance, I'll show you how to be treated right as a woman. So that's what Do Better is about, basically just being treated good, you know?
Hey man, I've just been recording a new album, recording new songs.
So new album when?
I don't actually have a date yet, but it's pretty much done. So it's like new album, new songs, new music, new vibes, you know?
Right. Yeah. Major League Gardens is coming up in a few weeks.
Yeah.
What's your plan? What are you doing on stage? What are you bringing?
Apparently you're hosting.
I'm hosting. I'm going to be there with you.
Yeah. Again, you were there last year.
I was there 2 years in a row.
2 years in a row.
That's right.
Okay, so I think we pretty much have to do something special this time. You know, it's our third anniversary. So we're going to have to do it big. You know, let's see what happens.
We're waiting for that video. It better start here. We want that scoop, okay? Thank you so much for the invite. Guys, it's the end of the show. I hate it, but what can we do? Remember, to catch all of this and more info and news, you can go on our social media pages, which is Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, at The Scoop Africa, and our YouTube page. Remember to subscribe, because that's where you get all the news and updates. Right? Right. Remember, it is Heritage Month. Remember yourself, know yourself, and know where you come from. Keep that going on social media. From us, SABC3, where the stage is yours and the scoop, I'm Khanyi Mbau, and good night.
We'll take a break, and then all the black people will meet and discuss what to do with the white people, as is tradition here at Black Soul. Two of you will watch the door, make sure they don't leave. This is what people think. There are white people when I post about the show on social media.
Why can white people come?
Like, how?